Hello, Planeswalker. Welcome to One Pack Magic, where we open one pack of Magic cards. And happy Chinese New Year. It is Chinese New Year. Year of the Rabbit, which is supposed to be of prosperity. So let's see how we can prosper with a pack of Dominaria Remastered. Now, I didn't get a chance. There were plenty of chances for me to buy Dominaria originally, but I never did. Because I think I was protesting Wizard at the time. For some reason. Or I just... busy. Mostly. Plus I didn't have anyone to play with. So. See what we can do. See if we can get another Rata. I haven't really looked at these. So I don't know what's in them. Yeet. Advertisement for Secret Lair. That no one's playing. I'm sure some people have some. Anyway, start off with Leaden Fists. Two and a blue, enchant aura, flash, enchant creature. Enchanted creature gets +3/+3 and doesn't untap during its controller's untap step. Well, yeah, because, heavy. Nomad Decoy. Two and a white, human nomad. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm kidding. Technically, 1, 2, 3, that's only 3. There's no 4 on there. Pay 1 white, tap target creature. Threshold, pay 2, tap 2 target creatures. Activate only if 7 or more cards are in your graveyard. Goblin Turncoat. 1 and a black, Goblin Mercenary, 2/1. Sacrifice a goblin, regenerate Goblin Turncoat. Regenerate, next time this creature would be destroyed, instead tap it, remove it from combat, and heal all damage on it. See, they've changed regenerate, because when I was playing, regenerate meant, instead of going in your graveyard, it'd go back on the top of your deck, and it'd go from there. So... which was really annoying if you had a skeleton and put him out. Someone killed it, put it right back in your deck, and just became a cycle. Oh boy. Fa'adia Seer. 1 in a green, human shaman. 1/1. Tap, draw a card, and reveal it. If it isn't a land card, discard it. Simple enough. Spark Spray. The artwork looks familiar, but it's not an artist I thought of. Anyway, single red, instant. Spark Spray deals 1 damage to any target. Cycle for 1. Pay 1 red, discard the card, draw a card. The Perennial Duress. Single black sorcery. Target opponent reveals their hand. You choose a non-creature, non-land card from it. That player discards that card. Penumbra Bobcat. Ooh. 2 and a green. Cat. 2/1. When Penumbra Bobcat dies, it's probably Penumbra. Create a 2/1 blank cat creature token. So he dies and another kitty comes in his place. Skirt Prospector. Single red goblin with 1/1. Sacrifice a goblin. Add 1 red mana. That's probably really good if you do like a goblin token deck. Phantom Flock. 3 white-white. Bird Soldier Spirit. 0/0. But that's flying. And when Phantom Flock enters the battlefield with 3 1/1 counters on it. If damage would be dealt to Phantom Flock, prevent that damage, remove a +1/+1 counter from Phantom Flock. Basically, you're fighting ghosts. Each time, it's less ghosts. Griffin Guide. 2 white, enchantment aura, enchant creature. Enchanted creature gets +2/+2 and has flying. When enchanted creature dies, create a 2/2 white griffin creature token with flying. That's not a bad deal. Basically, they have flying, and the griffin returns for it. Necro Savant. 3 black zombie giant. Giant? That one didn't work. 5/5. Pay 3 black, sacrifice a creature, return Necro Savant from your graveyard to the battlefield. Activate only during your upkeep. Damn. Thrawn Golem. Yep, you got some big golem energy here. 5 mana for an artifact golem. 3/3. As long as... Yep. My cat is checking out my shoes. As long as Thrawn Golem is enchanted, it gets +2/+2 and has flying, first strike, and trample. That is... Whew, that is nasty. And we got... The rare for the set, or for the pack anyway. Probably some, yeah, there's more cards. Body Snatcher. 2 black Phyrexian minion. 2/2. And when Body Snatcher enters the battlefield, exile it unless you discard a creature card. When Body Snatcher dies, exile it and return the target creature card from your graveyard to the battlefield. Oh, that's actually pretty good. Good little switchy. Alright, oh, we got a classic art of Spirit Link, single white enchantment aura, enchant creature, whenever enchanted creature deals damage, you gain that much life. I mean, literally, Life Link. But, I mean, we didn't, Life Link, I don't think, it might have been Urza, or it might have been later, because I don't. I think there's actually a card called Life Link that where this inspired. Or it might just be Spirit Link. Anyway. Oh, got a classic mountain. Which, classic border mountain. Oh, and we got a cat. We got a token cat. That is actually kind of creepy looking. Looks like he's ready to pounce. It's not the token cat for Noombra. Because this is created 2/1, that's a 2/2, so. But still, it's a pretty cool cat. No pun intended. Alright. So, what would I play? I do love Spirit Link. Like, is it Life Link now, but back in the day. So, yeah, I would definitely play that. I do like this Switcheroo. So, you know, like, you could ditch a big creature. Ditch like a 5/5 or something. Ditch like a dragon. Boom. And then when that creature gets killed, you can return... You can put that creature out on the battlefield. That would... Yeah, like, you see, put it, like, discard a big creature. And then when he dies... Boom. Definitely like this. Again, especially if you give it an enchantment. Oh, that'd be really nasty. Give it lifelink. So it's a 5/5 with flying, first strike, trample. And you're getting 5 damage each turn. That is pretty freaking sweet. I do like that. Like I said, sacrifice a creature and bring him back. Ooh, you create a cycle. But, you have to pay the 5. Ooh. I do like that. Give a 2/2 to something. And then even when it dies, you get another creature. Get a 2/2 griffin. That's pretty sweet. So I'd probably play that one. I do like this. Especially if you play cards that, like, add +1/+1 counters. You could essentially make this an unkillable creature because every time it's like deal damage. Oh, no, it's now a 4/4. Oh, no, it's now a 3/3. Nope, now it's back to being a 4/4. But I put another token on it. 1/1/1. Not bad. Like I said, put this in a goblin token deck. I pair it with, where's that other? Where's that bastard goblin? Nope. Pair it with him. Sacrifice a goblin, add one, sacrifice, regenerate. That'd be pretty cool. I think more just sacrifice a goblin, gain one. And since it's, you don't have to pay anything, you don't have to tap them, you could like, okay, ditch five, five red, boom, fireball. Fireball to the face. Again, I like that one. I would probably play that. Kill a cat.
That didn't come out right.
Just, you know, he dies, so you get another cat. Which is usually how it goes, anyway. You just, I mean, each cat is special. But, you know, adopt, don't chop. Yeah. Duress. One mana. Discard a card. Not bad. Usually that's blue's thing, but it's pretty cool to see them do it. Also, one, and cycle for one. I mean, it's an instant, so you could use it to take care of one pinger. I don't know. See, that's a, well, I wouldn't say 50-50. It's more of a, depending on how much land is in your deck type situation. Unless you threw it in there with some, like, graveyard manipulation, maybe it would work. But otherwise, eh. I mean, you got a tapper to draw a card. And if it's not the card you, if it's not a land, you're SOL. Maybe. Like I said, Goblin Token deck, maybe. Otherwise, kind of, especially for a 2-1. Unless you loaded them with something. But, no. Yes, but most, maybe. I like his Threshold ability. Where you can tap to tap two target creatures. Get a couple of, if your opponent is defending with some big guns, you just, nope, not anymore. Yeah, well, I mean, it's 3 mana for a 3/3, but it doesn't untap. So unless you found a way to untap it, I mean, eh. But I mean, you know, if you're doing blue, you'd have a way to untap creatures anyway. So, that'll work. Cat. Oh, looks like Teferi's wearing a cat mask. Teferi has become Catman. Or, well, Wildcat. That's a DC character. I don't know if Catman is a DC character. I know there have been parodies, but I can't remember if, like, officially. Anyway, that is Dominaria Remastered. I don't know. If they got classic cards like that, I might. Or I might just look for the actual, you know, go online and buy the classic cards themselves. Probably get some cheap. Yeah, just for the nostalgia effect. Anyway, this video has gone on way too long. I will see you tomorrow. Have a magical day, and happy Chinese New Year.